I have been living with HIV since 2004. I always experienced discrimination and stigma from the society, even from the healthcare workers. We feel the same when we go to clinics. We are ready to bring out the pain and suffering and talk to the doctors. But we are totally disappointed at the negative environment around us, as there aren't many counselors to help us or even proper counseling rooms for us to maintain the confidentiality. The services of the clinic depends on the doctor who is on duty. I believe there should be proper policies for this, and their capacities need to be built to be sensitive about our issues. We have to think twice, and we are worried of how they will treat us at the clinic when we have to go to the clinics. The whole world is saying treatment as prevention, but we don't have any confidence in the treatment and care offered at the clinics. We don't have any idea how long we will get ARV treatment. There are instances that the clinics run out of ARVs. Because of this, we are always in a doubt. We don't know who needs to take responsibility for this. We would love to have clinics free from any doubt which we can go to. There should be youth-friendly clinical services available at this clinic. I sincerely urge everyone responsible to help us create a safer space for us.
I am very happy to be a part of this discussion. I did not believe that I would be able to express my feelings like this. Today, I speak as a transgender. In Sri Lanka, transgender are rare. They usually imitate others and become a transgender. In Sri Lanka, it is very difficult to access surgeons because it is costly. There are so many other challenges we face. An example of an embarrassing situation we have to face could be that when we need a washroom break on our way while traveling, the choice we have is to decide between the male and female restrooms. If we choose female restroom, our voice is a problem and we are recognized as males and not as transgender. If we decide to go to male restrooms, we are treated as women and men make advances on us. These are just few problems we have to face in the society. The other most important challenge is accessing medical facilities. We are not rich. And if we have enough money, we could easily go for private hospitals and clinics. I was feeling so scared when I went to the government STD clinic, whether I will have to face any problem there. Though we are used to go to private hospitals, we have no choice but to go for services from government hospitals at times. But we face many inconveniences when we go to government-run clinics. The healthcare workers in hospitals are enjoying by laughing at us rather than giving us treatment needed. Therefore, we sometimes turn back disappointed and return without treatments. We are really helpless in this situation. Changing one's gender in a younger age is a big deal in this society. But we have to make our dreams and wishes happen. I am someone who stopped abusing drugs. It is very difficult to escort a drug user to a clinic. The reason behind this is that the drug users always try to find money for drugs rather than going for treatment due to the addiction. The healthcare workers always make us feel bad and look down on us as we were drug abusers. They always treat us differently and stigmatize us. They frequently say that we have that look of drug abusers. In these kind of situations, the hospitals doesn't encourage drug abusers to go to clinics to receive treatment. Because of this bad experience, any drug abuser who has been to hospital or a clinic will never encourage others to go for services. We are a part of this society. We grew up in this society. We also belong to this society. What I believe is as the best solution should be a train and build capacities of healthcare workers to communicate better and treat people like us better. Both doctors and other healthcare workers should have mercy and be human. Some of the drug users run away from hospitals and clinics as they have been embarrassed by the healthcare workers. Once I referred a drug user to a clinic. After the doctor did the checkups, the doctor called me and gave me a silly excuse and asked me to take him back. When I tried reaching the drug user, he had gone out to the sea for fishing and I couldn't reach him. What we are trying to say is that some of the services offered are not offered in a friendly manner and are not the best services that can be given to us. I have heard of the HIV rapid test available in other countries. I have heard that the rapid test is a much reliable test and could give the result of the test faster than the tests we have now.
එතකොට මේ මනුස්සයන් කොන් කරන්න ඕද නැහැ. මේ මනුස්සයන් මොකක් හෝ ක්‍රියාපටි පාටිකින් මේ මනුස්සයා එක තෝරගෙන තියෙනවා. ඒකේ මේ මිනිහා යන එක වැරදි දාරිද කියන හොයන එක වෙන එකක්. නමුත් සමාජයෙන් කොන් කරන්න ඕද නැහැ මට ළඟදී.
When I was trying to escort a group of patients to the hospital, our three-wheeler was stopped by the police and we were questioned about transporting drugs. This is one of the incidents I have faced. We have to avoid this kind of situations. I kindly request you to stop making us discriminate from the society. This is the only wish we have. I am a man who have sex with men and that's my sexuality. I have to face lot of problems because of being gay. Most of our rights have been taken away from us. If we go to a hospital to get our blood checked, they question us and discriminate us. That's not what we expect. What I believe is that we must have counseling centers with a competent counseling service to listen to us and help us solve our problems. I did my ordinary level exam, but I was unable to move to a new school to do my advanced level because of my sexuality. It was difficult to move to another school since I am having characteristics of a girl. I was really embarrassed when I went for an interview to enter to another school. My whole education was changed because of my sexuality. We don't have an opportunity to access a competent counseling service. What I believe is that we should get broader counseling on HIV and STI. A MSM becomes a male sex worker because of economic problems. We must pay more attention on male sex workers because they have a higher risk of being a HIV positive.
MSW ලා පිළිබඳව අපි වැඩි අවධානයක් යොමු කරන්න ඕනේ අවධානයෙන් සිටින්න ඕනේ HIV වලට තියෙන අවධානය.
I don't expect the government to legalize this homosexuality. What we expect is to have equal rights in the society.
සමායිතිවාසිකමක්ම අපිට තියෙන්න ඕනේ. මං ක්‍රොස්ඩ්‍රෙසර් කෙනෙක්.
I am a crossdresser but love to be a transgender. Transgender persons are not recognized both legally and socially.
උදාහරණයක් වශයෙන් නීතිමය පැත්තෙන් වුණත් සමාජීය පැත්තෙන් වුණත් ඒක කිසි පිළිගැනීමක් නැහැ. අත් වශයෙන් කරන මම තරුණේ.
I am a young guy. We have to face lot of difficulties when we live in this society. We are really embarrassed as people trying to define us in different ways. I am also entitled to the same rights which others are entitled to. I would like to spend my life happily like everyone else.
මට ගොඩක් අයිතිවාසිකම් තියෙනවා. ඒ කියන්නේ හැමෝටම තියෙන අයිතිවාසිකම් මටත් තියෙන්න ඕනේ. ඒ නිසා මාත් කැමතියි අනිත් මිනිස්සු වගේ සැහැල්ලුවෙන් ජීවත් වෙන්න. අනිත් මිනිස්සුන්ගේ ආශා.
Sometimes my sexual desires could be different from others. There are lots of people who wish to be transgender. But we don't have enough technical knowledge for treatment. The services and sensitivity in the society which is required. We usually select the women's queue when we are in a hospital. But the healthcare workers in the hospital want us to be in the men's queue. We are really embarrassed in this situation. In other countries, there are a lot more facilities for people like us, including free treatment. We don't get anything like that here. We need to lobby and advocate for strong policies to solve our problems.
අපිට මේ සඳහා මොකක් හරි ප්‍රතිපත්තියක් සාදා දෙන්න කියලා.